bring you another anime review. This time I'm doing it on Dragon Ball Super, episode 27. Earth explodes? The decisive Kamehameha wave. Alright, and this is the conclusion to the Revival of F retelling in Super. We see Vegeta go blue, battles it out, kicks Frieza's ass a bit. Then we see the feint. One cool thing before we get into the feint was Vegeta blocks a blast, a death blast from Frieza, and like ricochets it right into Sorbet, into the heart, finishing him. I thought that was pretty cool, as opposed to just blowing him up. Yeah, that was cool. All right, and so then, you know, Frieza goes into his feint. He drops out of Golden Frieza form and explodes the Earth real fast and kills everybody. And they show, you know, everybody dying, obviously, except for the people saved by Whis and Beerus. But the funny thing to me is, really? You're gonna tell me Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Vegeta died from a face blast to the, you know, just from explosion to the face of a planet? Really? I'm not sure about that one. And then, I understand that he can't breathe in space, but to claim somehow Frieza did live? And then all the other characters kind of died. I mean, I get it. But, like, these guys have been hit with so many powerful moves that the destruction of a planet in an energy shockwave shouldn't have killed some of these people. The exposure, you could argue the exposure to the space would. I'm just saying. But whatever. And that's going to be an interesting thing later on when people do the what if versus. Vegeta was killed by just destroying the Earth at point blank range. So, and that's at full Super Saiyan God with no damage. Yeah. All right. Then the you know, the whole go back in time thing to reverse what happened, and they did. And Goku killed. Goku killed Frieza. And then there was the wrap-up. One thing about the wrap-up, right? Gohan turns to Piccolo and like, dude, I'm sorry. You know, and even before that, he hugs Videl and Pan and is like, I have to protect you, you girls. I'm going to always protect you. See, this event should be humiliating to Gohan, right? He was so weak, he couldn't even last a second in Super Saiyan, right? Honestly, Mystic Gohan should have been able to trounce Frieza before. Frieza should have had to go to Golden Form to keep up with him. And let's not get me started on how weak Gohan has become. But this should scare Gohan enough to train, and he turns to Piccolo and is like, can I start training? He's like, yeah, man, you're rusty, but you definitely should start training your body again. So Gohan is going to start training. And this would excite me because I'm a big Gohan guy. I think most of us were. We're just not a fan of the wet blanket he's become as an adult. But, because, you know, young Gohan was always respectful, but he had that rage. Older Gohan is sort of like Clark Kent, minus the Superman. I mean, he does transform to the Great Saiyaman, but that's just him playing around. Honestly, I'm excited if Gohan does train, but we know he doesn't because we know some things from the upcoming manga. I mean, I've seen it. Listen, I have not followed the Dragon Ball Super manga too closely, only that I know what's coming, which is gonna start directly the next episode, which is going to be with Ciampa, and there's going to be a tournament between Universe 6 and 7. I mean, that's a spoiler alert. I'm sorry, folks, if I gave that away and you didn't know it. I'm sorry. But that's what's coming. And I do know, as another spoiler, because it's all over the internet, I do know who the participants are, and Gohan is not going to be one of them. And that's disappointing, because I'm excited for Gohan to get stronger. I do like the lineup, with the exception of the one weird dude. I wish they had just subbed in Gohan, but whatever. And Vegeta's, like, he has potential, and I think the comment from Goku is like, ah, but he's a father now. So, I don't know. What would be cool to me is if Gohan trains independently of this arc that's coming and does something completely different. Like, goes further with the Mystic and reaches a godlike chi, because Mystic is the beginning of God chi, right? So maybe he keeps going Mystic and something else, and he develops his own human Saiyan half-breed God mode, which would be cool. And it doesn't have to necessarily be blue. You know, there's so many different ways you can go with it. Heck, you could even, you know, I don't, doesn't matter to me. But I would like to see Gohan powered up and stop being a wimp. Here's the thing. There are a lot of mistakes that GT made with the cast that a lot of people hated. And I don't see them going... I want to see them fix that in Super, right? They don't have to go the same route GT went, right? Gohan doesn't have to remain a pussy. I mean, he doesn't. It just doesn't make any sense for him to remain that way. And I know people are like, well, that's where his character grew to because of his mom. And yes, that's true. But this should shock him that he needs to be stronger to protect his family. He can't rely on his father. And he needs to be there. At one point, he was the most powerful being in Z. So he needs to get back there. Hit the weight room, you know what I'm saying? So there's that. And then I just hope they don't go that same route, you know, like, oh, these guys are gonna be this way, and Goten's gonna be into girls, and like whatever. There's ways to tweak it, and Trunks isn't gonna be like future Trunks. He's gonna be a little more none of that bullshit, you know. One thing we were mad about GT is we wanted Trunks to turn into Trunks, future Trunks, more or less, you know what I mean? You wanted to see Trunks mature into future Trunks, not a slightly pussified version. And all the kids kind of didn't go well, in my opinion, in GT. They should have went, their characters went south to me. So, I am glad, however, that they're not. Because I always found that if you weren't a Saiyan in the series, you were just useless. And so I like the direction they're headed now. But, you know, I've talked too much, not about this episode. Let's get back to this episode's review. Let me turn it back around. I went off on a tangent. So, this episode is a 3 out of 5. It was a good wrap-up, a good conclusion. I thought the effects on the exploding Earth were really nice. There was one weird effect in the fight where, animation-wise, where Vegeta is above Frieza, and you see Frieza, and then the landscape below him, like the water and island. I don't know what, it felt like an unfinished CG, so I don't know if they were trying for pseudo-realistic, whatever it was, it looked weird, but that's my nitpicking. But again, 3 out of 5, I thought it was good. All in all, I would rate this saga a 3.5 out of 5, as opposed to Battle of Gods, which would be a 3. Because I thought this retelling was better, and in many cases expanded the original. In places it was, story was lacking due to pacing. So I did like that. But that's enough out of me, because I've talked a lot about Dragon Ball. So in summation, super excited about next week's episode. Finally, new stuff. But, you know, that's next week. So, click it up if you like it. Comment if you must. Subscribe if you can. And share if you please. This is your buddy, Alert Wolf, signing out.